In the past month, I have done 2 weddings. I love being a part of the couple's lives and knowing them personally because I know how much that day means to them. I always tell them that the day is the second greatest decision they will ever make. The first, of course, is giving your heart and life to Jesus. One of my favorite parts of a wedding ceremony is the moment the bride appears to the groom for the first time. She's wearing her wedding gown and she's in white and presenting herself to her husband for the rest of her life. I love to see the look on the groom's face when she appears. At both of these weddings, the grooms just started crying. So when they saw her, they were just overwhelmed with emotion. Well, of course, when they start crying, I kind of started tearing up. Or as I tell my students, the air got really dusty and made my eyes water. But in that moment, the anticipation and excitement is so overwhelming. I want you to hear this verse in Isaiah 62, verse 5. And as the bridegroom rejoices over the bride, so shall your God rejoice over you. Did you catch that? It says the Lord rejoices over you. And also check out this verse in Zephaniah 3:17. For the Lord your God is living among you. He is a mighty Savior. He will take delight in you with gladness. With His love, He will calm all your fears. He will rejoice over you with joyful songs. How amazing is it to think that He rejoices over us with songs? His love for us is so much bigger than we could ever imagine. We see in the Bible that we are called the bride of Christ, that He is coming back for His bride, and there will be a marriage supper of the Lamb. But I want you to picture this. When we step into heaven, I believe that the roles will be reversed. When we see our groom Jesus, we will be overwhelmed at His love for us. We will see the nail-scarred hands and feet. We will know in that moment a love like we have never known before. Revelations 21:4 says this, He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death or sorrow or crying or pain. All these things are gone forever. I don't know about you, but I look forward to the day I see my Savior, and I know that I have made it home.